Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be exploring Gion and all the surrounding shrines just to get the touristy stuff out of the way. I am here with my mum in Hoshino Coffee. It's a really cute coffee shop and it kind of looks like an old-timey train, and it also reminds me a little bit of Tokyo Ghoul because all the coffee here is hand-dripped and it's just got that Tokyo Ghoul vibe. But yeah, I'm really excited for today. I just ordered some pancakes and they're like the big fluffy type and I've never tried them before. So I'm quite excited to try those. And the coffee is really, really good. So I do recommend this place if you are in the area. Kyoto is very, very cold now, which I'm actually really surprised about because when I came here with Angelina, it was much hotter than Tokyo, but actually it's freezing. I'm wearing like two layers today. I'm wearing a coat and a fleece. So you can definitely feel the autumn and winter coming in. But yeah, I'm just waiting for my food and drinking my coffee, and then we're gonna go and explore Gion. So pretty. Can we go that way actually? Yeah. There's a wedding happening as well. What a beautiful place to have a wedding. Do you know what's funny? When me and Angelina went to Nara Park, there was a wedding happening in Nara Park too. Everybody's taking pictures of them. Oh, she looks so pretty. Reminds me a little bit of Sensoji Temple, the Hosomon gate. We just found some stairs in a very foresty area and we're gonna go up them. Well, at least I am. Are you going up, Mum?
Yeah.
So it looks like we have discovered something very, very pretty. I'm actually not quite sure where we are, but once I find out, I'll let you guys know. Amazing. I feel like Lara Croft right now. So we just found out where we are, and we are in Chōraku-ji Temple. And nobody is here. It is completely empty. The area outside is so packed full of tourists, but this is completely, completely empty. It feels so peaceful and so zen. So it costs 650 yen per person to come in here. So it's quite pricey, but it's completely empty. It's amazing. I'm so impressed. Past 2 days we've just been in the middle of huge crowds of tourists, but here there's just no one else, it's just us. So zen. I feel my spirit getting cleansed. So we have made our way down to the main area again.
What?
So this here is the tea ceremony room. So because the floor is tatami, I'm gonna take off my shoes and you place them there. Oh my goodness.
So this is where you would have a tea ceremony. With a beautiful garden, and you can sit here and look at the garden.
I don't know if they take bookings for tea ceremonies, but if they do, this is a pretty cool place to have them. Also, the ceilings are very low, and I'm very tall.
So just in front of the garden, they also give you some little shoes, in case you want to have a walk around. And I do. I want to see where I can go, so let's do this.
If you're coming to Gion, then I highly, highly recommend you visit the Chirakoji, because it's so peaceful and so beautiful, and I feel like it tells you a lot about the history of the area. And also, best of all, it's not touristy at all. There's nobody here. We stumbled here by complete chance. My mom saw a little road that kind of led to nowhere, and then we turned right and there were just these massive steps, and we're like, yeah, let's go up there. But discovering this place and walking around this place makes you feel like you're in a different world, like you're in Uncharted. I've also noticed that hanging off the trees are like little silkworms. I think they're silkworms. I'm not sure, but like little tiny caterpillars, and they're hanging on like a very thin thread. It's very cool. And I would love for us to have a tea ceremony here, but we only have 2 days left in Kyoto, so we probably won't be able to. But if a Japanese tea ceremony is something that you wish to experience, then maybe this place is worth checking out. It's very nice, and this is actually my first time experiencing a proper tatami mat. I haven't like been to anywhere that uses tatami mats. I don't think I have. But next week we are going to Hakone, and we're going to be staying in a ryokan, which I am very excited about. I've never stayed in a ryokan before, so we'll probably see more tatami mats there. But this is my first time experiencing a proper tatami mat, and they're very, very cool, very comfortable to walk on. Yeah, definitely, definitely check out this temple. But it's so peaceful here, you kind of don't want to leave. Especially now that Kyoto is quite busy, a lot of tourists come to view the leaves changing color. I bet when it snows, this temple would be beautiful. Okay, so now we're gonna go and grab a coffee in the Starbucks that we saw earlier, because it reminds me of Violet Evergarden, the scenery from Violet Evergarden so much. It's like the perfect place for a Starbucks. I realized that I'm in a Japanese tea room and I'm talking about Starbucks. That's a new low. Wow. But still, I'm looking forward to my coffee.
There's my shoes.
Oh, there's lots of leaves on the floor. Look how nice the leaves look. Yeah, they're so little. Oh, so pretty. No, but I guess we can put them in like my wallet or something.
So we are in this beautiful temple garden area. Super beautiful. A wild monkey appeared. The wild monkey bites brutally. Don't feed him and don't fight him. Even if you fight, you can't win. What? I don't even know where we are anymore. But it is beautiful.
Okay, I am just shook at how beautiful Kyoto is. I am shook. Wow. They're just incredible. And we saw a rainbow above a temple space. Isn't that crazy, Mum? So this whole area is full of shrines, is full of temples. It's very, very beautiful. You could easily spend a whole day here, easily. The architecture is amazing, and I feel at peace. I feel zen because I got away from all the tourist groups.
Touch the roadside Buddhist statues in Hageishiyama. Touch these beloved Buddhist statues and altar objects to earn merit. And it's Hotte, a pot-bellied deity of good fortune. Cool. So let's touch and hopefully earn some merit.
Okay, so you're supposed to touch them with your right hand or both hands. So I'm going to touch them with both hands and earn good merit. Okay. That was strange.
Kyoto has so much to offer. Don't be afraid in getting lost and exploring all the hidden streets, because chances are you will come across some amazing little sights. And if you're lucky, you might even be able to spot a real geisha or maiko. We actually did see a real geisha. I wasn't recording at the time because we were on our way back, but the few geishas that currently live and work in Kyoto tend to be more discreet. You're most likely to see them going to their next appointment down some of the side streets as opposed to around crowded areas. This is it for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, please don't forget to leave me a like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I will talk to you next time. Bye.